I just want to let you know a little bit more about how I do my painting. So I'm going to let you in on the process from start to finish on how I create my canvases that I paint on. So this is a board that I usually get at Home Depot. I usually get like a composite board, but I started getting the real wood because I find it a lot better. And I also get the sidings at Home Depot as well. Usually I get a 4x2 board, which is something like this, and cut it down to size, or include another 4x2 to make a bigger piece or a bigger canvas. But usually I go by cutting everything down, and then in the corners I do a 45 degree angle so everything just stays flush against each other, and decrease the number of seams on the side. And then a lot of people don't know where I get my records from. I want to keep it a secret, but I get a stack of records all the time. As you can see, some of these have been warped a little bit. They've been in a car over the summer. But I get a stack of records all the time, wherever I go. That one's good. So I get a stack of records, and I break them down into little pieces. These are some of the little records that I get. But I break them down, I cut them down to size. And then once I have my canvas done, I put them on a canvas, lay them out, some of the smaller pieces, as you can see. Then I line it up to however I want it to look, make sure the flow is right or something, make sure everything looks, you know, pretty much seamless when I do it. And this is something of the finished product of the canvas after I gesso it. So this is like the whole record. This is a broken one, broken after I glue it down and gesso everything down. So this is like a finished canvas. I even have the whole, that was a bunch of records. I even have the hole I cut out for the speakers. Let's go over here. And you can see this is something that I use to cut the holes. So I cut it, and then in the back I lay the speaker down and glue it in. But now I started screwing in the sides. I've got better speakers nowadays, so I can screw those in to the back of the canvas. And this is how the canvas looks. As you can see, the 4-point corners right there, seamless, staple in the back. So there's really nothing you can see on the side, and it just makes it look a lot better when it is finished. So this is like a finished canvas that I would go on top of. After that, I would include a amplifier somewhere in the section, and then screw holes at the bottom to feed out the power supply and the auxiliary cord. So this is just a little bit of insight on how I do my paintings. So the canvases are all handcrafted by me, and I make sure I pay attention to detail when I do it to just give a better feel to that canvas, a better feel to the speaker, because each of these paintings I see as little boom boxes for people, a little conversation starter for people when they put it into their house. So I want to make sure that it really looks good, that it really gives a good sound when we play. So this is the back of the speaker. Like I said, when it's finished, when everything's done, speaker, the amplifier, the cord coming out the back, as you can see. And then this is something of the finished product right here. Hey guys, I want to let you know a little bit more about the speaker and amplifier component. So this is the Louis Armstrong piece that I have for sale. You can see the speaker right there. And I showed you guys the actual speaker and the amplifier installed in the back. But when I paint live or during my work in progress sessions, I have the amplifier hooked up. I have the power supply hooked up, cords all hooked up, and this is actually playing Nujabes So I usually have something jazzy playing, and you can just hear it.
Man, it is hot.
Soul Chef. So anything you have in your phone, this is my iPhone 4S, so anything you have in your phone or your MP3 player or anything that can be hooked up to a headphone jack can be played on the paintings. So you can have a Droid, you can have your computer, you can have anything, your small iPhone, iPod Nano or something like that, any MP3 player, hook up to these paintings. So when you're at your house and you hook it up, you can have a dinner party, you can just plug this in, your phone in to the painting, and jam out with friends and play whatever. You can have dinner parties, and this painting is basically a conversation starter. That's one of the reasons I like it, because it's not just a painting, it's something that you can talk about, it's something that you can actually use, like a boombox. You can use this with anything, so definitely check it out, and check out some of my other pieces at my website, www.detourartstudio.com. Peace.